the RWA Cruiserweight Champion, Jay Ice. Real quick, guys. Hey, Bird, stop putting people to sleep with the rules. We know them already. Real quick, I just want to make a quick announcement. First off, I want to thank everyone that was here last month that donated for my nephew, Dominic. I broke down in the middle of this ring last month, and it's kind of not my style, but I want to thank you all again because you helped us give him a great Christmas. Also, we are still taking donations for the next couple of months. If you want, you can see myself at my table or that young lady in the blue shirt there. If you guys have any you wish to give, what's up with this thing?
Stop trying to.
Your equipment sucks. It's worse than the last guy.
Oh.
Now, I also have another announcement for later tonight. So I'm going to let Bert get back to doing his job. And you guys go, and I'll see you later. Ladies and gentlemen, Jay Ice! Give it up for Dr. Fieldman!
Hello everyone, it is a new year here in RWA. I am your host, Michael Darcy, joined by the one...
Shut your mouth! I am your one and only wrestling Reverend Church, and everybody knows me by now after 5 years.
5 year anniversary here, RWA. This is big, Church. Big. And I mean 5 years going strong. You were here since day one.
I've been here since day one. I've seen a lot come and go. RWA has survived the entire five.
And no one thought we'd make it this far. And I tell you what, we're here stronger than ever. And it's all because of that. Dr. Feelbad. Even though he's not the nicest boss in the world, I will give him credit where credit is due.
He's always nice to me.
Of course he is. That's because you really know how to keep... Never mind. Dr. Feelbad making his way to the ring right now, and I'll tell you what, Church, 5 years going strong, I think we make a damn good team to survive for 5 years.
I know, I'm the leader of this team.
I wouldn't say
Hello.
That.
Hello!
Alright, back to...
Welcome back! And anyone new, thank you for being here. If you're first-timers, we're going to try to knock it out of the park for you tonight. Thank you. Thank you. 5 years thanks to two things. All the fans that supported us for 5 years, give yourselves a round of applause. And also, most importantly, the wrestlers in the back, no matter if they're rookies or if they're 20-year veterans of their craft, and I know they can hear my big mouth, whether we've had differences or not, or whether we're best of friends, whatever side of the fence it might be, we always come together to put, what I, dare I say, the best indie promotion anywhere around. And if you agree, let the rest of the world hear it.
Cheering tonight.
It's been 5 years. You can still call him the River Dirt.
Yeah, damn right.
Unbelievable.
No, I'm fine. Special attention to, we have even touched fans and people that have never been able to attend this show. For example, the Sutton family, Kovacic family, over here, and we went the camera on them. Your grandmother's first name again was Helen. I thought I wasn't something like freezing up here. Helen Kovacic passed away on New Year's Day at the age of 88. Now wait, she never attended an RWA show. But Lauren Sutton, Robert Sutton, and her family have attended many events here. And the highlight of this woman's night was when they went home and showed grandma the pictures, just still pictures of RWA, or occasionally when something would leak to YouTube. And it's a proud moment for me that we can touch somebody like that that's never, whether it be a disability or an illness, never had an opportunity to be here. But I've met her twice. She was a strong, wonderful woman. You should be proud. I was proud that she was a fan from afar, and I'd like to dedicate tonight's show in honor of her memory. You're welcome. Now, as much as you love me, who wants me to shut up and get the show going?
I've never heard.
You're not getting a t-shirt. You are not getting a t-shirt. Security, throw her out. Let's hear it. Please. Yes. Yes. RWA.
Wow, look at this. And it is a celebration and a half here.
I thought someone hated me enough to finally kill me. Wow. Wow, thank you, I think.
Hemorrhoid flare up indeed, okay. When it comes to Dr. Phil.
Without further ado, a little late, huh? Couldn't get it up, could you, John?
Ouch.
Took you a while. That's because I wasn't working this side and working my magic. That's what it is. I was over here and, yeah. Don't let him fool you, he couldn't get it up with a crane. Oh!
Wow.
I love you. No. Oh, touche. Now, I'm gonna shut up. Let's start.
Go back.
Uh-oh.
Weighing in at a combined weight of 440 pounds from Acorn, Pennsylvania, the Enigma, Lucio DeVere, and his partner from Carlisle, Pennsylvania, Bulletproof Danny Abel.
Put his music on.
No, that's not it. Danny Abel and me had a conversation backstage. He does not want to be in this matchup. He feels that he is too talented to be in a tag team match. That's why he walked out on his opponent last month.
Well, we'll see what happens.
He really doesn't want to be tagged with Lucio DeVere, who I think Lucio DeVere is a very good choice for a tag team partner. Uh-oh. Bulletproof Danny Abel and the Enigma Lucio DeVere, and I'll tell you what a hell of a way to start off RWA today.
Why did you say it like that?
What do you mean?
Just say hell. It's much easier.
I said hell.
Yeah, but you kind of like lowered your tone on it. Like
okay.
You didn't want to say it. Just say it. It's okay.
Unlike you, I don't have a potty mouth, but oh, Danny Abel now already trying to get the crowd going, and he has his hands full with Shane Andrews. Shane Andrews. Well, wait a minute. Already tagging in.
Apparently, he doesn't have his hands full with Shane Andrews.
I guess not. Shane Andrews has quite the training. Trained by Mr. Fuji himself. Martial arts background, this guy. And he's already going to work here on Lucio DeVere on that arm. Twisting, screaming, and grinding. There he goes.
I thought he looked a little Asian.
He's not Asian. I'm just saying he was trained by Mr. Fuji. You don't have to be Asian to be trained by an Asian.
Why the hell not?
Unbelievable. Andrews now, look at the agility. And bouncing back here on DeVere's.
He could get away with being a Chinaman.
Oh, wait a minute now. Andrews, all these guys are going back and forth here. Oh, shot to the ribs. The bad boy, Shane Andrews. Sending Lucio into the ring. Oh, shoulder block by DeVere. DeVere off the ropes. Up and over he goes. Where he stops, nobody knows.
That's where he stops, on the mat.
Hip toss, then an arm drag. Another one, and here we go, folks. This stuff's already picking up here, and bad boy Shane Andrews in control now.
That extra foot of hair is starting to wobble a little bit. That means that his power is weakening.
No, it means his height's going down. He claims to be 7 foot tall because of the hair. Oh, there we go. Lucio Devere now trying to take control of Scott Sarin. Both these guys have gotten the short end of the stick lately. Wow, did you see the rough tag right there between Abel and Devere? These guys do not like each other.
Well, you got two people that don't want to team with each other, that don't want to be in tag team matches. But guess what? They got put together, so let's see what kind of chemistry they have. Let's see if they can actually put their differences aside and get a W in the win column.
First of all, by the way, beautiful leg lariat by Uniontown native Scott Sarin. And I'll tell you what, again, a tag, an unwanted tag.
Uniontown. Nobody wants to be from Uniontown.
What? Oh, come on.
That's a junk town.
Unbelievable. You're going to trash, wait, not only West Noon, you're going to trash Uniontown.
Why not?
There's something wrong with you. Okay, back to the match. Devere in control of Sarin. Now, both these guys have had a short end of the stick as of late, Church. And, I mean, both of them have come so close but so far away in their matchups. And another thing. Oh, wait a minute now. Sarin backing up. Oh, smart tag team wrestling tagging in the bad boy, Shane Andrews. Devere in that corner now in trouble. Takedown by Andrews. Oh. Oh, smart.
Ow.
Oh, my goodness. Another one. Andrews off the ropes. Boom. Flying low clothesline, one, two, and no.
I was a practice dummy for a spinal tap one time, never again.
You were? Unbelievable. I never taken one, I just, that's not my thing, that's why I commentate.
I'll make sure that Jay tries one out on you next time.
No, thank you, you keep your friend to yourself. Okay, now, Devere in control now, taking it to bad boy Shane Andrews. Well, wait a minute, Abel wants a tag now. Telling him he can handle it himself, denying the tag to Danny Abel here. Two in.
Two count only by Bilbo Baggins.
His name is Bo. Bo Browning. Can you not get that right?
Brown and Surf.
Unbelievable.
Golden rolls.
All right, Abel with the blind tag and a smart one.
At least it's not golden showers.
Up and over, and there's that amateur background wrestling. One, two in, Abel. Again, amateur background there, and he is showing it right now as we speak. Oh, wait a minute now. Using those ropes. Oh, my goodness. Talk about some strangulation there.
I've never seen somebody bend that way before.
Oh, well, there's always a first time for everything. And I'll tell you what. Oh, look at this. One thing about this man that I've noticed, he personifies arrogance. Very cocky, is Danny Abel.
I kind of like it.
Of course you do.
He's very full of himself, very arrogant. He wants to show the world why he's here. I don't blame him.
Did you see how he took him down? Again, that amateur background, that amateur wrestling background coming into play here. Danny Abel's using his control here. And now Danny Abel in complete control. And this team might actually work out now. If these two could just get on the same page, they could be a dominant tag team. I could see that. Oh, knee lift.
Coulda, woulda, shoulda.
And did you see that again? Lucio Devere sneaking in the tag.
I have a feeling that this poor communication between, hey, wait a minute. Anyway, I'll call that one. That is our first plate of chops. Oh! Those were our first plates of chops served here tonight at Open Season 6. Good God!
And first of the year, Church, and I'll tell you what. Talk about a receipt.
Woo!
Oh, I seen skin fall off of Lucio's chest there. And wait a minute.
Those are tenderized pork chops.
Andrew's in trouble now, and oh my goodness. Again, Andrew's neck got to be hurting him. I mean, my God. Both these guys have been using that rope. Oh, both knees to the spine, and Shane Andrews is in trouble. One, two, and no.
Two counts, says Bilbo.
Danny Abel's getting kind of fed up here, it looks like. And Scott Sarin, a human weapon, just waiting to get back in that ring. What an explosive youngster Scott Sarin is. Oh, back and forth now. Shots to the gut. Shane Andrews coming back here. The bad boy. This man's wrestled in TNA and WWE. He has a lot of experience under his belt here. Shane Andrews now. Wait a minute. Reverses it. Devere's into the ropes. Ooh, kick to the chest. Here comes Lucio. Spinebuster and a beauty.
Wow. That is going to make your spine tingle. You're going to need a chiropractor.
Something happened to me like that, there'd be a mess in my pants. I'd be scared.
There's a mess in your pants all the time anyway. That's why you wear the pants.
I don't wear the pants.
Yes, you do.
I only had that one accident. It was a long time ago. Back to the matchup. And, oh, Saren in a ring now. Up and over. Leg lariat and a beauty. Sending Saren. Wait a minute now. Reversal Saren now in the opposite guard. Here comes Abel. Ooh, kick to the face. The human weapon to the second rope. Up. Beautifully executed drop kick. Unbelievable. Danny Abel's in trouble, Church, and I'll tell you what. Oh, wait a minute. Getting himself out of harm's way. What? He just tagged his partner, Lucio Devere, and just slingshot him in the ring. What's Abel doing now?
I think Danny Abel's done.
What the heck? Wait a minute. Is Abel walking out on his partner again?
Yep. He's looking for his baby back. He wanted, he's leaving.
Leg lariat by, I can't believe it. Leg lariat by Andrews. Now Saren lining him up in. Oh, my goodness. The kick by Saren. 1, 2, and 3. It's over. Saren and Andrews are victorious.
The winners, the team of the human weapon, Scott Saren.
Right?
And the bad boy, Shane Andrews.
Shane Andrews and Scott Saren victorious. But no thanks to Danny Abel walking out on Lucio Devere.
Kick from Scott Saren takes another one out.
The biohazard kick, and I tell you what, it was a vicious one, and knocking Lucio Devere completely out. But then again, Devere's focus was more on Danny Abel than it was Saren and Andrews.
First award to give out this evening, voted on by you, the fans, at our live events and online at rwalive.com, is for the most improved wrestler of the year 2013, here in the RWA.
Ryan Edmonds.
What?
The winner of that award is...
G Raver today. He just doesn't seem like himself. Wonder what's going on with him.
G Raver, while you're here,
Go up and pat him on the butt. Maybe he'll feel better.
I'm not you, but G Raver cleaning house
Ladies
again.
Ladies and gentlemen, as voted on by you, the fans, the most popular wrestler of the year 2013.
Church.
In the WWE, G Raver.
And the G-Raver Awards continue.
They do. Man, is this crowd going bananas for G Raver. Most popular.
I'm going to file a petition to have the names changed to the G Raver Awards.
The G Raver Awards?
Yeah, the G Raver Awards.
Hey, why not?
I want to take a minute for you guys. I'm not going to take up too much of your time. It means the world to me that you guys feel the need every year consecutively. And I want to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. I truly appreciate every one of you. But guys, aside from the awards, one thing that I've sat and thought about for a really long time is that no matter how many stunts I've done off a ladder and crashed through a table, no matter how many beatings I've taken, no matter how many times I've gone into thumbtacks and ladders, what has that really got me?
You have the support of 150, 200 people on welfare.
I was on a quest
Are
for that heavyweight title, and how many times did I get so close? So close, but not close enough. You're right. It is a new year. Now hold on. That means a new year for a new start. There's something I gotta do. And you know what? I don't even know what that is. But like I said, as much as I thank you guys for this, I gotta do something. It hasn't gotten me anything to kill my body, to almost break bones, get concussions and fracture, whatever else. So I gotta think of something, guys. Until I figure it out, I'll still be here. We'll see where it goes.
Some strong words from the award-winning G Raver.
G Raver, before you go, I know you got a big match tonight. Before you go,
you said that once, Bert.
On behalf of the fans who voted in the RWA's year-end results, a little choked up here. The 2013 RWA. Wrestler of the Year!
This man has won Wrestler of the Year here at RWA. What an amazing feat. Yes, I know titles mean everything to these guys. But again, G Raver, Wrestler of the Year. Once again, his second year in a row.
Here at the RWA, other wrestlers haven't won awards too. And I'm about to present one right now. And no, G Raver can't win this one. He's not eligible.
I was about to say, Some of us are the Susan Lucci of RWA. We never get nothing.
The award for the best newcomer who made his RWA debut in 2013.
Congratulations, Scotty.
And now we have one more award. And to help me present it, I know he wanted to say a few words himself, the owner of the RWA, Dr. Fieldman!
Wonder what this one is.
Well, we have a special award here. And by the way, the awards that were not presented, such as Most Hated, Tag Team of the Year, whatever, they were not here to accept the awards. We want to encourage you to go to the website. The results of all categories will be up within a couple of days at rwalive.com. Thank you.
Kind of got to guess who knows.
Turn the attention over here to the broadcast team. An honorable mention, as much as sometimes you get under my skin, Doc, you are fantastic, sir, what you do.
Wow.
Thank you for being a part of this, just for the love of it. And I have much respect to give you on that. But you're always worried about chasing Katie around all the time, and you missed a couple of shows. So, the RWA Special Recognition Award goes to my buddy Church for perfect attendance for 5 years. Please come up here and accept this. And hurry up. Come on up here. Church, let him hear it. And your own t-shirt. Buddy, I appreciate it. This says Special Recognition Award, 5 years perfect attendance, and professionalism.
Professionalism? I'm not going
to
go there.
Give it up for you. There you go. That'll look good on you. That's it? Quick words.
Wow.
You know, I'm just going to say this. It's been 5 years. I've been here since day one. I know a lot of you people have been here since day one, too. And we have seen a lot of people come and go. It is not about me making this show. It's about those guys back there making this show. I wouldn't have a job making fun of them and all of you if it weren't for them. So this, while this feels wonderful to me, thank you so much. This is for all those guys back there too. Thank you.
Church, the winner. Make you fall in love. Oh, wait a minute. I already have you up under my arm. I used to ball of my tricks. I hope that you like this, but you probably won't. You think you're cooler than me. You got designer shades just to hide. They got their own signs? Are you kidding? Ash Hammers and Ryan Reid making their way to the ring. Remember my name, and we They have signs. Ashton Amherst and Ryan Rain have their own signs.
I'm glad that they decided to come out right after I was done. That's awesome.
Yeah, isn't it? Let me tell you. You got your Lodi fears Ashton, are you kidding me? Lodi don't fear anybody.
I'm glad you guys came out because I am going to make this short and sweet. Yeah, I really believe that. Yeah, you're exclusive, that's good. But we gotta keep the talking to a minimum. You guys were not scheduled to have any talk time, but I'm gonna let you have it because I'm gonna let you choke on this one. Tonight, hold on. I love you, you know that, I do. You used to carry Feel Bad Five's bags. Don't forget that.
Ouch. Wow.
Now,
talk about a low blow.
As much respect and admiration I have for you, tonight is a special... You're a good athlete. Tonight is a special night. Very special night. And I'm going to say this first, and I'm going to admit it. I've been guilty of cheating. We've been guilty of taking shortcuts. But this is a five-year milestone. We're gonna give these people 100% their money's worth. Don't tie me, because they're gonna love this. You are banned from ringside tonight in this man's match against Brady Pierce. You are banned. And he's banned from yours.
Finally, some justice here in RWA.
We are not going to allow it tonight. It's a special night. And you know what? You went from carrying the bags to earning it. You're going to...
You're done. When he opens his mouth, you shut yours! Just when you thought these two men couldn't get any better looking,
what?
We walk out looking like this. But Brady Pierce, I can promise you, this is so much more than a pretty face. Now when you look in the record books, it's gonna say last month that you beat me. But in reality, we got everything we needed so that I can beat you tonight and take your championship. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank you for attending our night. Because at the end of the night, RWA will be exclusive.
And they start.
Why do they do this?
And the beauty of this is, I had a lot planned that I wanted to say.
I don't have to tell you about
that. But after I look at someone like you, I need to go in the back and throw up. The bottom line is this. There's two title matches tonight. That guy's walking out the PA Regional Heavyweight Champion. This guy's walking out the RWA Heavyweight Champion. Because I'm the best in Pittsburgh. And we are exclusive!
Well, you heard it here. Wait a minute.
Well, now.
I think Ashton bit off a little more than he can chew. But you did hear the news, Church. Ryan Rain banned from Ashton's match. Ashton banned from Ryan Rain's match. We're going to have two legit title defenses here tonight. Commentary, they're banned, which means they're not allowed. I will make sure they're not allowed here.
Well, who died and made you commissioner?
I don't know. Maybe they should be voting for me for commissioner. But we're not going to get into that right now. We're going to get into this. Hook is the title, and it's not. It hasn't looked any better than it does around that man's waist.
Did somebody call me? I think I heard my name.
This crowd going bananas for the Arthur.
Encourage him.
Shut your mouth! You know, we don't have to wait till the end of the night to do this. Instead of waiting for the main event, we can go right now. You want to go right now? You fans want to see it now?
We're going to have our title defense now.
You want to see it right now? Just as dumb as all these people. It's 2-on-1. Bring it on and we'll kick your ass.
Oh, wait a minute.
Two
things
on
just
one.
Got evened out.
2-on-1.
There
Did
he
you
is.
Say 2-on-1? Do you fans know who Brady Pierce is?
Making his way to the ring now.
Do you guys know who Brady Pierce is? Because if you don't know, this is Brady Pierce.
That's a huge individual right there.
I think instead of waiting, we need to go right now.
And here they go, and there he goes. Exclusive out the ring, running away as usual. Both Emerson Reigns staring at what they got to deal with later tonight, Church, and I'll tell you what, if I'm Ryan Reigns or I'm Ashton Amherst, I'm shaking in my boots.
Well, Ashton Amherst and Ryan Reigns are not going to mess up those $500 suits that they spent money on for these two. They're going to do it once they're in the actual ring.
I was going to say, I kind of seen the one suit for sale at Penny's. I don't know if it was $500. Just saying. But, exclusive, and wait a minute, Lodi just using, wait, they're leaving the building. They're going around the ring. They don't want nothing to do with Brady Pierce or Lodi. And I'll tell you what, the RWA Heavyweight Champion, the PA Regional Champion. Oh, look at that. And Lodi ruining the sign, the blasphemous sign of Ashton Amherst. And tonight is going to one hell of a title.
Making his return
to the RWA! Weighing in at 265 pounds from Boone, North Carolina, here is William the Hammer Roberts!
What do they put in the water down there?
I don't know, but William the Hammer, Mr. Roberts making his way to the ring, and I'll tell you what, this man wants some redemption. I actually had the luck, you could say, of bumping into this man, and I'll tell you what, it was not a fun sight. I asked him where he's been, and he said he needed to get his head on straight.
He's the size of a house. How do you not bump into him?
Yeah,
and I mean that with all due respect.
Very, very scary man. But tonight, we have a pretty much a matchup, strength versus speed, as I want to call this match. Hands down, strength versus speed. Both of these guys established here in RWA, and another man that needs no introduction. I'll just let Bird take it away. Excuse me, Mr. Roberts. Mr. Roberts versus John Schuyler. Yes, I am not allowed to call him William the Hammer Roberts. I'm only to call him Mr. Roberts. And when he tells you to do something, you do it. S- Skyler taking on Roberts, and I'll tell you what, I am looking forward to this contest. One hell of a contest here at RWA.
Everything's one hell of a something to you, isn't it?
Shut up. Just do your commentary.
You see this award?
Are you gonna rub that in my face?
This means I'm better than you.
That don't mean nothing. Anyways, what does mean something is this match in a ring, which is strength versus speed. Skyler versus Roberts, excuse me, Mr. Roberts. And we're gonna get this thing started. They're gonna lock up here. And again, the strength.
Strength beats speed every time, unless you're talking about the drug.
G. Raver's proven that fact wrong. Wow, what a set of cojones on Sean Skyler. That is one bear you do not want to poke, slap, or anything. Oh, wait a minute, Roberts missing. Oh, shot to the face, and Skyler coming back here, going to town, delivering the goods here to Mr. Roberts. Oh
God.
Oh, my goodness, and oh! Skyler threw that opposite corner, tossed like a sack of potatoes, and Skyler back at it again, delivering the goods. Oh, European uppercut and a beauty. Forearm by Skyler. Skyler pulling everything he can out of his arsenal here. The big man hasn't found his feet yet. Skyler off the ropes, up and oh, shoulder block by William the Hammer Roberts.
John Skyler was hitting and moving. Unfortunately, he hit and then he didn't move.
No, he didn't. I'll tell you what, though. Oh, shot to the ribs. William the Hammer Roberts now displaying that strength we were talking about. Up and over. That wasn't even a hip toss. That was called pretty much a potato throw. Like a sack of potatoes just tossing John Skyler here. And now, Mr. Hammer in the control, delivering those rights to John Skyler. Oh, vicious headbutt and a beauty. Sending Skyler into the ropes, up and over, back elbow. And Skyler is down. One, almost only a one count on that one. I was a little shocked on that. Skyler able to take some abuse here.
John Skyler's hurting for certain, that's for sure.
Mr. Roberts now, ooh. Skyler with a right. A chop.
How's your
a
mama?
Right. And ooh, big knee lift. Mr. Roberts
that's
again.
That's an old kitchen sink to the breadbasket.
I'll tell you what, Skyler just hit Mr. Roberts like pretty much like a kitchen sink with that drop kick. Skyler now, here comes that aerial assault. No, my goodness, what a beauty.
Up and over, John Skyler goes, proving that if you put enough momentum behind yourself, anything's possible.
And Skyler in control of this matchup finally, trying to get these fans riled up here in RWA. This West Newton faithful. And Skyler better not give him so much room. He's giving them enough time to breathe, Church. That's dangerous, especially with William Roberts.
Don't want to let the Hammer recuperate, because when he does, he's going to cause pain.
Oh, did you see he missed it? He went head first into the pole there.
Good call. I did see it.
Just stating. And wait a minute now. Roberts, Mr. Roberts, rolling himself back in the ring. One, two, and oh. Oh, we had a three count. Another one, two, and no.
Two again. Count only. Who is that referee? What's his name?
I don't remember. Ron.
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 We'll just go there. Oh, European
uppercut. Frickin' referee's name is Ron.
Couple chops here. Skyler now. Uh-oh. Are we going to get the 10 here, folks?
John Skyler throws. We're at 5. Potatoes in the corner.
One more. He better hit him. Oh, I knew it. Mr. Roberts up and over, and oh my goodness.
Hot shot off the top rope, and Skyler's down.
Skyler's neck, I mean, just yanked off that top rope, and oh my goodness.
Oh, well, that's just pretty to see.
Hey, crush larynx, maybe. Never can tell.
Come on, Ron, get in there.
And now, Mr. Roberts in complete control of this matchup. Just delivering the goods here.
Do you see on here it says professionalism?
Are you going to keep talking about that award? Shut up. All I ever got from this place was a chili dog. Oh, shot to the corner
five
now.
5 minutes gone by. 5 minutes.
And William the Hammer Roberts, excuse me, Mr. Roberts in complete control, throwing John Skyler at Opposite Girl 2-0.
Two count by Ron.
But again, power versus speed here, and William Roberts showing what side he's on now, squeezing the life out of Skyler. There's a bear hug. Is he going to tap? That's the question.
John Skyler's back has got to be hurting him. William Roberts, the Hammer, as I like to call him. I'm a friend of his. He
You're
won't
lucky.
Admit that, but I'm a friend. Has been working on Skyler's back when he has had the chance to, and Skyler is not in the best of shape right now.
Well, Skyler, though, trying to get the momentum from that crowd. I mean, my God, his ribs, his kidneys, his pancreas, it's all getting crushed here. Oh, headbutt. And Skyler getting out of that bear hug. Thank God. I thought we were going to see a tap out there. And oh, my goodness. Bear pull to the back. And what a clothesline.
Almost a lariat by the Hammer. Working on the neck once again of Skyler.
But then again,
two count by Ron.
Look at the face. Look at the frustration of William the Hammer Roberts, though. Oh, look at that. Shot to the gut. But again,
punch to the
solar.
Sorry, punch to the solar plexus. Ineffective by John Skyler.
But again, Mr. Roberts has Skyler in that bear hug.
I'm bringing solar plexus back, by the way.
Great, great. Proud of you. Okay, but back to the matchup. Squeezing the life out of John Skyler.
John Skyler looks as though he is basically out on his feet. Ron checking his hand.
We got a one. Got two. One more, and this is over.
Ron says no. We did not get to three. Good job, Ron.
Do you really have to torture all the referees like this? Really? Uh-oh, headbutt. Another one. Skyler taking pretty much a page out of William Roberts' book here. Mr.
Roberts. He's biting him.
Hey, you got to do what you got to do. Yuck. And the Hammer now up and wait a minute. What agility to his feet. And we had a sleeper hold by Skyler. We can see an upset right here, Church. We can see an upset right now. Mr. Roberts in trouble. Skyler latched onto him like a spider monkey. Oh,
the size and power of William Roberts will be neutralized if he gets put to sleep by the, what'd you call it, spider monkey?
He's latched onto him like a spider, a spider monkey.
There for a second, I thought you said porch.
I'm not going to go there, but anyways, Jesus. John Skyler, again, not giving up on his sleeper hold and jumping on the back of Mr. William Roberts. He is just trying to get the big man down. He's down to one knee. He's down to one knee. This could be it. Referee in position.
Ron is checking.
This could be it. Mr. Roberts could be out on his feet. Wait a minute. Back up in. Oh, wait a minute. Sidewalk slam. And Mr. Roberts getting himself out of harm's way. We almost saw the Hammer go to sleep there.
Almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, Doc. We're not playing either one of those here tonight at Open Season 6.
And that's our first one of the year. Okay, so back to the matchup.
And many more to follow.
Oh, kick to the midsection. Mr. Roberts has him up. And big suplex. And he snapped that beauty.
For a man the size of William the Hammer Roberts to snap suplex you, do you realize how fast you are going and how high you are going?
Definitely. I mean,
that's gotta hurt.
Yeah, but he did it with such precise quickness. I mean, did you see the back of John Skyler, the spinal, just bam, right off the ring.
He did it
kick to the midsection.
With quickness and ferocity. And there he goes again.
There he goes again. And look at the pain on Skyler's face right now, holding that back.
It's as if William Roberts can hear me talking about it, and he's like, let's go with it.
Little ESP?
It's possible. We are friends. He won't admit it, but we are.
Who aren't you friends with? Okay, back to the matchup.
You.
Well, according to the... okay, wait a minute. We can have another one here. Another suplex. This could be the end of John Skyler. Oh, he got him up. Look at the power. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, knee him to the head. What a defensive move by John Skyler.
Way to think on your feet there, well. Yeah, way to think on your head, Skyler.
Skyler up. Two clotheslines. Can't get the big man down.
He really wasn't.
He's going one more. Oh, Roberts missing. Oh, and he's down. Skyler got the big man down.
Good.
Skyler asking for this crowd support here.
The height that Skyler got up to kick William Roberts in the head.
Up and over he goes. Wait a minute. Oh, back elbow to the face. Wow, did you see that? Right through the ring, a missile. One, two, like a missile. John Skyler just pushed himself right through the ropes and just, what an attack.
Ron said two.
Uh-oh, wait a minute. Skyler now lining up. Got that foot ready. We're going to see a super kick here, maybe. Up and over. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, the big man catches him. Oh, kicked in the midsection.
This isn't going to be pretty.
The hammer has him
up. Oh,
powerbomb to the corner. Here comes Mr. Roberts. Oh, big boot to the face.
Did you see the back of the neck and the head hit the top turnbuckle of John Skyler?
This could be it, folks. One, two, and no! John Skyler kicked. I can't believe he kicked out of that.
Two count by Ron.
Nobody survives that kick. How many times have we seen Mr. Roberts boot somebody in the face? They've needed like two people to help him out of here.
Well, maybe Ron can't count right.
I can't believe you. Leave the referees alone, please. They've complained about you numerous times. Up and over, catches him. Wait a minute, Skyler now. Oh, sends him opposite corner. Walks it up. Oh, what a maneuver. This could be it. One, two, and no. I can't believe Mr.
Two
Roberts
count.
Just kicked out of that.
By Ron.
There's something wrong with you. This crowd getting behind Skyler. I cannot believe again. Both Roberts and Skyler playing, pretty much having the match of the century right now. Kicking out of each other's pretty much finishers here. And wait a minute now, Skyler, where he's most dangerous, the top rope. Oh, look at that.
Ron, what are you doing?
Mr. Roberts using the referee. Oh, wait a minute. Up and over, and boom, the hammer. One, two, three, it's over.
Ron falling into the ropes, causing Skyler to fall. William Roberts taking full advantage and taking out John Skyler.
And Mr. Roberts victorious again. What a despicable move, though, using the referee to his advantage. But again, Mr. Roberts, who's been on pretty much a hiatus for a couple months after losing the PA Regional Championship, is back here in RWA.
It looks as though he is back to his winning ways here in RWA, thanks to Ron.
John Skyler can't believe what hit him. He knows he's been cheated out of this, and I'll tell you what, again, using the referee to knock Skyler off those ropes, if that referee wouldn't have been there, I think this match would have been a different story.
Yeah, well, it's all Ron's fault for falling into the ropes. He wasn't pushed. Don't you dare say that Mr. Roberts pushed him, because Mr. Roberts will not be happy with you.
He did. He pushed him. I saw it.
Do you
want to
see the hammer come over here?
No, he can stay right
well,
over there.
Well, then don't say it.
All I'm stating is the fact that he did. Unbelievable.
Oh, quacky hand yourself. looks like she's gotten sassier since last we saw her.
Sassier? How can you tell?
Just look at her.
Did he just really wipe drool off his face?
How's everybody doing tonight? Are you glad to see Sassy Steffi back here in RWA? Now, feel bad. I know you're very excited to be back with me out here tonight, but Jesse Bell and I, we're a tag team at Shine. We're friends, so tonight, I don't need your services. You can head to the back. We're going to have a nice, clean, friendly competition tonight. Thank you.
Did I just hear those words come out of Sassy Steffi's mouth?
And her opponent.
She's never been clean and friendly.
I don't know.
Now, this has been all over social media for RWA. A lot of people have been looking forward to this young lady making her way to the ring. Smothers making her way to the ring. Now, all over the RWA sites, I've noticed a lot of fans have been wanting her to come to RWA. A lot of fans have actually pushed for her to be in the female wing here of RWA. That's right, the ladies' competition here in wrestling. I'll tell you what, we are in for a treat. Two talents here. Wait a minute.
Well, she's filling Bilbo up.
Now, these two actually, I did some homework, and I'll tell you what. I'm surprised Sassy Steffi has a new attitude, pretty much. But these two do tag team. They are undefeated in the they're undefeated tag team. And tonight, you get to see who the better of the two is, basically, is what this is going to decide here, Church.
Well, we got the Sassy one versus Jiggles.
Versus what?
Somebody ring the bell. It's over.
Why are they... And it's a...
That was a quick count.
Bo, you're going to be a married man here soon. You can't be doing stuff like that. Having some fun with the referee there. And I'll
good job, Bilbo Baggins.
Again, friendly competition between these two. No strangers to each other. Tag team partners. And Steffi trying to start things off here. Twisting the arm of Smothers. And wait a minute here. Back and forth they go. And now Smothers reversing it on Steffi. Again, these two, no strangers to each other. Twisting the arm here.
While I am a fan of the Sassy one, I want to know where my new friend is.
What do you mean your new friend?
My friend. You've been making fun of her for months now.
Who are you talking about, your new friend? I haven't been making fun of anybody. I don't make fun of people.
Yes, you do.
Who?
It's all on tape.
Okay, sure it is. And if I think you're talking about, first of all, we need to concentrate on niece tutoring, not Sarah Feeney.
It's about time you said it right.
No, you're the one that always called her Shirley Feeney.
You did.
Oh,
I never would have said that.
You're despicable.
She is a wonderful lady.
I'm not going to go there. All I'm going to say is this. First of all, Jesse Bell Smothers in control. Wait a minute here. Sassy Steph rolling her over for a pin.
Sassy versus Jiggles. One-on-one.
What? Why are you calling her Jiggles?
I don't know. Isn't that her name?
No.
What's her name?
Jesse Bell Smothers.
Oh, well, hell, I got it all kinds of wrong.
Yeah, calling her Jiggles. Stop it. It's very ignorant and sexist of you. And now Smothers in control here, the reverse chin lock here. Oh, wait a minute here. Now, oh, shot to the ribs. Another shot to the ribs. But I did have the unfortunate experience of running into Miss Feeney backstage.
She's not happy with you, is she?
No, she's not.
That's because you've been making fun of her name for months and months and months.
That was you.
That was you. It's all on tape.
Look at the leg scissors by Jesse Bell Smothers. I'm going to ignore you and just go back to this. And, oh, wait a minute. Sassy Steph almost pinning. These guys, lots of chain wrestling between these two ladies. Wait, up and over. Catches her. What?
Grab her butt.
What?
What? I didn't say anything.
Sassy Steph now. Oh, thought we had a Oh, we might have a three count here. Smothers and Steffi going at it. These two know each other too much. That's the thing. They know each other. Tag teams. Back and forth now. Shot to the kidneys. Smothers off the ropes. Shoulder block. Knocking the Sassy one down. Here she comes again. Up and over. Sassy Steph. Oh, clothesline. Now, we've seen a lot of rule breaking from Sassy Steph in the past. Are we going to see it tonight? I'm wondering if that temper that we all know about Sassy Steph is going to come into play here.
Two by Bilbo Baggins.
It's Bo. The
Bilbo.
Referee's name is Bo.
Bilbo.
I give up. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Reversal by Steffi.
Jiggles into the corner.
Oh, Smothers. Shot to the midsection here. Sassy Steph takes her down. Up and over. Oh, kick to the back. And what kind of move is this?
Stump puller? Are we going for a stump puller?
I think we might be. Oh, no. It's kind of like a rearrange Jesse Bell's face here. That's not good.
Yeah, it looks like somebody's already done that for
And I'm going to call that Sassy style. Two and almost a three count.
The hell did I just see?
I call it Sassy style. We're going to call it Sassy style.
All
right. Oh! Full Nelson into pretty much a...
Ass slam.
There you go. Ass slam. We'll use that. We're going to coin a couple of these. These are some amazing maneuvers by these females.
That's why my plaque says professional.
Wait a minute. Wait!
There's my friend. Hey, look, it's
what
my friend, Serafini.
Serafini.
Don't you call her Shirley.
Oh, my goodness. I never called her Shirley. But back to the match. I can't believe it. She just interfered in this matchup. And like I said, I ran into
her. She's going to beat the crap out of the referee if he's not careful.
She wanted to let the fans know of RWA that she's the self-proclaimed hottest girl in the room.
Phil, guys, get in here. Yeah, I want to talk to you. Get in here. I know you're out of breath. Get in here.
Feeney looks a little upset right now. Sarah Feeney asking the owner of RWA to get in the ring here. What is going on here?
Every month, who shows up to the show? Me. Who promotes the show? Who represents the women's division? Me. And how do you repay me? By putting these two bimbos in a match?
Bimbo! Wow. Strong words from Sarah Feeney.
Bimbo!
So what do you have to say for yourself, Phil Bad? Real classic, what do you have to say for yourself?
First of all, I know you'd like a three-way with any of them. Hold your wand up there. Well,
wow.
You know, did you ever stop and think that I can't figure you out? You've been fooling around with a tag team division and wrestling men. But you know what? We've had enough talking tonight, and we need a lot more action. Who wants to see her in action? I mean, you look geared up and everything.
Wait a minute.
Restart the match. It's a three-way now.
Steffi rolls her up. One, two, and oh, wait a minute now. Smothers, two. Oh, look at this. Just a constant bunch of roll-ups here. Feeney. Oh, these two. Hey, she called them bimbos. Now she's going to pay the piper.
Well, they are bimbos.
What?
You heard me.
Up and over and feeding down, getting what she deserves.
How dare they double team her? That is just wrong.
Hey, you reap what you sow. She interfered in the match and she won an action. She's getting a double suplex by Smothers and Steffi here. Feeny in trouble. The self-proclaimed hottest girl in the room.
It is not fair to beat up on my friend Sarah like that.
Oh, wait a minute. It is definitely a freeway here and Steffi again.
I've heard Sassy's good at three ways.
Clothesline. Oh, really? Oh, rake to the eyes and Feeney now. What is going on here? Coming out of here and getting a piece of Jesse Bell Smothers. And suplex to the floor. Owie! Feeney's not playing.
She is angry.
She wants to show that she's the lead lady here, leading lady here in RWA. And she's proving it right now.
I like an angry Serafini.
Flips over. Oh, did you see the neck of Sassy Steffi whip back in? Oh! Flying knee to the face. Feeney. One, two, and no.
Two count only, says Bobo Baggins, screwing Serafini.
What?
You heard me.
She's not getting screwed.
She just got screwed out of a win.
Because Bilbo Baggins can't count to three.
His name is Bo. Second of all, it wasn't a three count. It was a legit two count. Quit it. Quit sticking up for somebody who just pretty much turned her back on her own friends.
You're the one that keeps calling her Shirley Feeney. She is really upset at you about that. And I have to keep correcting you.
Hold on. This is my ignoring face. You see it? Good. Okay, now Feeney. Oh, Feeney caught with his 2 feet. Steffi to the second rope. Sat the sassy one. Oh, catches Feeney with the forearm there. And wait a minute, Feeney now. Uh-oh. We're going to see a superplex here from Sarah Feeney, the self-proclaimed hottest girl in the room. Yes, you heard me right.
Well, she is.
Superplex and a beauty. Feeney delivering the goods. This could be it, folks. One, two, and no. Smothers now breaking up the three count.
Jiggle's interfering.
Jesse Bell Smothers.
I'm just going to go with what I call her.
Fine. And Feeney now taking control of this matchup. And she is handling her business in this ring. And I'll tell you what. She's mad as hell that she was not included in pretty much our anniversary show here at RWA and all, man.
Well, can you blame her? The anniversary show is one of the biggest shows of the year. It is where we started. It is the fifth year, a big year for us. And she was excluded off the card because of you and Dr. Feelbad.
What do you mean, me? I had nothing to do with it.
I know you went to Dr. Feelbad and was like, nobody wants Shirley
Catches
Feeney.
Her. Oh! What a maneuver by Sarah Feeney. She has just taken both of these competitors out. Oh, wait a minute now. Wait a minute here. What the heck? Smothers and oh, dropping her on her face. Jesse Bell Smothers, one, two, and three. It's over. Our newcomer,
victorious. Here is your winner, the wild-eyed Southern girl, Jesse Bell.
You know,
Smothers.
Jesse Bell Smothers, victorious here. And how sweet it is. Sarah Feeney got what she deserved.
I'm calling shenanigans. Bilbo Baggins has a crush on Jiggle Smothers, and that's why he gave her the win.
Jiggles? Smothers and Sassy Steffi now fighting amongst each other. Finally, they put the tempers aside. Like again, these two, an undefeated tag team in many regions here around the Indies. And I think they both agree, Sarah Feeney was just ignorant, pompous, and arrogant. Oh, wait a minute now.
Hey, what the hell's going on here?
Oh! Hey, they had to teach Sarah Feeney a lesson. Sarah Feeney going in, interfering in the matchup, calling them bimbos.
They are bimbos!
You don't even know them!
I do know them! They are both bimbos!
Sarah Feeney down in the middle of the ring. Hey, she wanted action. She got it. Jay Ice's birthday is in January. We're back here in RWA.
Cruiserweight champion Jay Ice! Now, I'm going to ignore that thing you said about me earlier, boring the fans. About 5 minutes ago, you told me you had something else to say.
Yeah, thanks. You can leave now, thank you. So, listen, guys. What? No. I don't feel like beating up on old men today. Actually, you know, what I want to say is actually somewhat serious. It's not as serious as last month. I want to thank you guys again for that. Where'd Lex go? Lex! Hey, Lex! Come here.
Ready, Sorg?
I need you in here for this. It's actually pretty important. Hang on.
What is going on here? Something. Jay Ice has something up his sleeve, and usually, wait a minute, he's bringing a chair.
The chairman,
RWA. Didn't you dub him that there?
I coined that phrase myself.
Yes, you did.
Sit down. Sit down. You trust me, right? You trust me? She trusts me. That's a plus, right? Listen, you and I, we've done a lot together in the last couple of years. And you're my best friend up and down the road. And I know that you've been going through a lot right now. Will you shut up, dude?
Finally, somebody.
Basically, all these people are right, and they've given away my secret. We talked about how you hate me. Hey, feel bad. Come here. Hurry up. No, I know. I forgot something.
This is like watching the Benny Hill show in a way.
Jesus. I'm gonna ask the sound guy. Can we dub the music, the Benny Hill soundtrack over this?
Something. I don't know. Now she's left in the middle of the ring. Alexia waiting for this big announcement. Couple people giving it away here.
What the hell?
Wait a minute here. Balloons galore.
There are a lot of balloons there. Good Lord.
Listen, we talked about how you hate rings. So I got you these instead.
Wow.
Lex.
Oh no, wait a minute. Oh my God.
Oh, what's going on?
What a son of a. Oh no. Blackwell just ruined a beautiful moment for Jay Ice. Here we go. These two hate each other. Finally, a chair all to the midsection, and the chairman of RWA is struck here. Finally, that's it, Jay, get him. Oh my goodness, and Blackwell caught. Did that really just happen?
Joseph Blackwell has a budding feud here with Jay Ice. He does not like Jay Ice at all. And I guess proof is shown right now, interrupting what is to be a beautiful moment here in RWA. We don't have many of those.
It was a beautiful moment, and then Blackwell ruined it, I guess. Joseph Blackwell, I mean, these guys have been fighting for what, 2-3 months now? Such a hatred between these two. I mean, he just capped Alexia with that clothesline. I think he was going for ice, and he missed ice. But still, you don't get violent, especially during a moment like this. This was a special moment.
No, absolutely not.
They're going to finish this. He's going to do it here right now.
Oh, God, he's back.
Oh, my goodness. Blackwell again. Son of a bitch. Oh, my goodness. Are you kidding me? No. No, 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 no. Oh, he misses. Ice coming back here. These two battling back and forth. Throws him out of the ring. Finally. Oh, this is not stopped. This is just, I think we have ourselves a street fight. And oh my goodness. Ice beating the living hell out of Blackwell right now. Thank God. I'll tell you what, Joseph Black, what a despicable act we have seen tonight. I can't believe it. Ice now. Oh, kick to the midsection now. Joseph Blackwell, pretty much he wants that cruiserweight title. And I'll tell you what, Church, he is just, he's a man possessed. And across the back we go. We are having some, wait a minute here. What is this about? Alexia trying to like defend her man, but I mean, you're not gonna do, oh, wait a minute, no, Ice. Pushing him to that post now. Oh, knee lift to the stomach. And this is just getting out of control. If Blackwell does something here, there's something wrong with this individual and he should be banned from RWA. Oh, oh my God. Back to the, just put that in his back. Oh my God, that's the back of his neck. What's he doing? He's choking the hell out of Jay Ice right now. Oh no. Again, shot to the spine. I mean, that could do some internal damage, Church.
That could break some ribs. That could, there's any number of things that could happen.
What the hell does he have on his, he just wiped, oh my God, there's blood. Oh my God, Jay Ice is, he's hurt internally. But Ice still fighting though, he's still fighting. There's a lot of fight left.
Jay Ice proving why he is a champion here in RWA.
Taking him down, oh, spinal tap. And look at that, Ice couldn't even hold himself up, Church. He is hurt, I mean, he is down. I mean, he is spitting up blood. Ice can't even walk right now. I mean, Blackwell took that, what, took that chair a few times to the back of his, to lower back, excuse me. I think there's been some internal damage to Jay Ice. Jay Ice is down, folks. It's not looking good here. I think these two were actually scheduled to fight tonight for the Cruiserweight title. Oh my God. Come on, Jay. What the hell? He got the belt now. Ice can't even get up to his feet. Come on, Blackwell. This is done. This is enough. You've proved your point. Oh my God, he hit him with the title. Oh my God. We need to get security out here now. This isn't even supposed to be sanctioned. Oh my God. Wait a minute. Oh no. All Alexa could do is just stand there and watch. Oh, don't do this, Joseph. No. No, damn it. No. A concerto delivered. Not another one. Not another one. Oh my God.
Doc, I gotta go check on my friend. I gotta go. Thank you.
Scotty Matthews. And he's on his way to ring. There he is. Tell you what, this man right here has made such an impact here. An impact here in RWA. One of the most pretty much gifted
and
wrestlers
here.
His
opponent!
Here with Scotty Matthews.
I want your soul. I want them both right now.
A whole new attitude in life, and I'll tell you why. Billy Brash, if you noticed the last month or two, all about partying, all about having a good time. This man here has felt disrespected. He was put in a cruiserweight battle royal, which even he felt more disrespected. He basically told me, Doc, I'm pissed off. And I said, well, now what? He goes, I want serious competition, and tonight the party stops. I mean, congratulations. This man just recently had a baby also. So very proud, proud parent, but I'll tell you what, new attitude in this man, and I'll tell you what, it could actually do him some good here in RWA.
It could. Having an attitude like that will get you definitely noticed and
liked by you, definitely.
Absolutely. I am definitely a fan of Billy Brash.
What? You were saying you hated him last month?
No.
Are you kidding me?
And why did you say that you hate people? That's not nice.
Billy Brash has a huge man standing behind him. Wow, he just jumped all the way out of the ring. Hey, if it was Scotty Matthews, I'd jump out of the way too. So Billy Brash wanted serious competition, and Church, he got it. Fearless Scotty Matthews.
He's got it. Scotty Matthews and I don't see eye to eye. He doesn't like the fact that I call these idiots river dirt. I don't really care. If you want to be an inspiration, I could care less one way or another. But leave me and my river dirt alone.
First of all, they're not your river dirt. They're the fans of the RWA.
River dirt.
Thank God me and Mr. Matthews see eye to eye when it comes to that. You are very disrespectful to the fans. You don't deserve that professionalism award.
Professionalism, baby.
And Brash, oh, wait a minute. Speaking of professionalism, Brash just slapped Scotty Matthews in.
That
oh, here we go.
That was just plain old dirty, and I like it.
Shoulder block by Matthews and a beauty. Off the ropes he goes. The fearless one stepping over. Wait a minute here. Sends him up over. Oh, wait a minute. Brash rolled him up and oh, what a maneuver, Street Fighter style. By the one, the only, Scotty Matthews, big body slam, and Billy Brash in trouble, drop kick. What agility this big man has. And there he goes, reverse chin lock by fearless Scotty Matthews, and I think Billy Brash bit off a little more than he could chew.
Just a little bit. It's gonna be one of those strength versus speed things again here in this match. As long as Ron doesn't screw it all up, we're gonna be good.
Are you going to pick on a referee some more here?
Possible.
Professionalism. Unbelievable. And now Billy Brash with that elbow catching Scotty Matthews, squeezing the head of him. Referee right in position here to try to catch. Oh, wait a minute here. Shot to midsection. The solar plexus.
Solar plexus bringing it back.
Off the corner. And again, Matthews with those shoulders. Oh, wait a minute, to the top rope, and oh, wait a minute, Brash caught him, and I tell you what, brilliant maneuver by Billy Brash. I'm seeing a new attitude, and I'm kind of liking it here just a little bit. Billy Brash taking his job a little more seriously, and you have to, especially against Scotty Matthews.
Absolutely.
Foot on a rope, referee on top of things here.
Good job, Ron Swoggle.
What?
Ron Swoggle.
I guess you gave him a name now. Great. Both our referees have made up names for me. You realize this?
No, that's his name.
Oh, reverse chin lock in the back of that neck over the knee of Brash, too, and kick out by Matthews.
Two count only by Ron Swoggle.
He's very happy to run into my friend Scotty Matthews. He's like, Doc, I'm back. I was like, yep. So he's back, ladies and gentlemen. Scotty Matthews, and I said to him, is there any titles you're going to go after? Is there anything you plan here in RWA? His exact words were, he's here to make noise, Church. No titles, no nothing. The fearless one, Scotty Matthews, here to make noise. I didn't think he was coming back tonight. He surprised me.
So he said, hi, I'm back?
Yeah, pretty much. Hi, I'm back. Just like that.
Okay. Man of few words, huh?
He's always been a man of few words. You should know that by now. I got to get that stuttering thing down.
Yeah.
Knee to the back, and I tell you what, look at that stretch in Scotty Matthews. Billy Brash in control of this matchup. Something a lot of people, we might see an upset here tonight, Church. Especially with this new developed attitude of Billy Brash.
Ron Swoggle checking to make sure that Billy Brash didn't put this into an actual chokehold, which even if he did, he's got the count of five to break it, so why not use it?
Oh, and slammed to the canvas, and Billy Brash now.
Strength by Billy Brash, because let's face it, Scotty Matthews is a big man to take him down. Strength is what did it.
And he's catching him with them forearms now, Church, and I'll tell you, oh, look at this. He's giving Matthews enough time. Oh, wait a minute, here he. European, oh, I thought it was a European, but I caught him in spinal tap. Oh, he misses with that kick at all. Brilliant maneuver by Brash. Catching him in that pin and all, oh, kick to
two
the
two count
head.
Only, says Ron Swoggle.
Yeah, but Brash kicked him in the head, Church. That could be it. We could be seeing a concussion, something. Oh, reverse neck breaker. One, two, almost a three count.
Simply ravishing by Billy Brash.
Well put. Brash in complete control of this matchup. Like I said before, wouldn't this be something? Billy Brash would put his name in the record books as a win over Scotty Matthews. Oh, man, another one.
Would be something to beat the, what was it, the RWA's most improved newcomer? Or what was that award he
made? Most improved, or no.
Come on.
Most popular newcomer, basically.
Most popular newcomer. Okay, there we go. So the most popular newcomer to be beaten here tonight, that would take the air out of the sails of one Scotty Matthews in that award.
Well, speaking of air in the sails, he just took it out of Billy Brash, picking him up and just dumping him right on his head.
5 minutes.
Two count by Ron Swoggle.
Can you just say the referee? Maybe he doesn't like to be called that.
Maybe I don't care.
All right, Scotty Matthews reversing it, sending Brash in the opposite corner. He misses. Oh, kick to the face. Scotty Matthews now trying to catch him here. What's he going to do? Fighting on that apron. That's pretty dangerous there.
He just kicked him in the head.
Hey, Scotty Matthews. Man of many treats here. Oh, using that head for a battering ram. And wait a minute. Oh, man.
Ow. That's just a straight slap to the back.
If someone heads down to that floor, it's going to hurt. Oh, my God. I think they both sent each other's head off the canvas there. Or, excuse me, off the ring apron. And that's pretty hard place of the ring. These guys are knocked out. Or light on their feet.
Well, I don't think they're knocked out. I mean, otherwise almost they'd be both out. They'd be laying down.
Pretty much,
not
yes.
Not moving.
Meant to say
they're,
almost.
They're both moving.
Okay, thanks, Church.
Pay attention to the new monitor.
Brash now up, delivering the goods to Matthews. We can see a double count out maybe here. Someone doesn't get in that ring. Oh, he caught him one.
Billy Brash in, and Scotty Matthews in.
And these two again continuing the fight back in the ring where it belongs. And Matthews catching him with that left. One, two, and no. Sends him into the ropes. Back elbow. Matthews has him up. Misses. Off the ropes he goes. Oh! Human somersault, basically. Flying somersault. Like a battering ram. Here he comes. Clotheslines him. One, two, and no.
Two count by Ron Swoggle. Billy Brash is still alive.
Billy Brash is still alive. And I'll tell you what a back and forth matchup. Billy Brash giving it his all here. Like you said before, the party's over, Church. And Matthews catches him. Oh! And wait a minute. Brash caught him, reversed that. Pretty much like a reverse Russian leg sweep there. Brash had, oh, wait a minute, Matthews has him up. Oh! One, two, three, it's over.
Here's your winner.
Matthews caught him.
Fearless.
And just drove him to the
corner. Matthews!
Ron Swaggle giving the V to Scotty Matthews.
Man, that is one scary man right there. Fearless Scotty Matthews. I'll tell you what, Victoria's here. He does not like you at all.
I don't care. I don't like him.
That's fine.
As long as he stays away from me, we'll be good.
I tell you what, I can see this man moving up the ladder. I can see this man being a future RWA heavyweight champion. Scotty Matthews, Fearless Scotty Matthews. A man of power, faith, and just respect. And I tell you what, every wrestler should be like this.
That is saying a lot. Scotty Matthews has all the potential in the world. He can make his way through the RWA roster.
A man who won the PA Regional Championship.
This man is exclusive.
And he has no help tonight either. So full of himself, a man who's arrogant and pompous. Ashton Amherst and him making probably one of the most arrogant teams I have ever seen in my entire life, which is exclusive.
And his opponent.
This man thinks he's untouchable, but a man almost, a man who is almost defeated and almost tapped out. That's right, Brady Pierce had him up that torture rack, and then there was that outside interference of course, your commentating buddy, Ashton Amherst.
Ashton Amherst would never interfere in a match.
Weighing in at 245 pounds, and wrestling out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, it is the RWA Pennsylvania Regional Champion, the Inspiration Brady.
Brady Pierce making his way to the ring. And I'll tell you what, this man right here, PA Regional Champion, one of the most powerful PA Regional Champions I've ever laid eyes on. Brady Pierce is not out to defend his title tonight. He's out for revenge, especially against that pompous, arrogant asshole. Excuse my language, Ryan Reigns.
You can't say asshole.
You just did too.
I'm professional. I can get away with it.
I apologize, folks. God, I need a Tylenol. But all I'm going to say is this. Ryan Reign, one of the most arrogant, ignorant people here in RWA. And I'll tell you what. I will give Ryan Reign where credit is due. The man has established himself. This man has started from the bottom and worked his way up.
He has.
And I will give him that. But he has the wrong attitude when it comes to wrestling.
No.
Yes, he does. He runs his mouth way too much, and he associates himself with the wrong people like Ashton Amherst.
How can you say that Ashton Amherst is the wrong kind of people? Ashton Amherst is the best in
Do you
Pittsburgh.
See how far we are away from the corner? You want to know why? Because we need enough room for Ashton's head. I was almost smothering myself when I was sitting here in commentary. He thinks too much of himself, and then he's influencing young people. Excuse me, young wrestlers like Ryan Reign here, filling their head full of, I mean, Brady Pierce is a powerhouse, and Ryan Reign thinks this is going to be a cakewalk. He's wrong. He's very wrong.
Brady Pierce might be a powerhouse, but if there's one thing that always stands true, and that is this, brains will always triumph over brawn. And if you have the best in Pittsburgh in your corner, at any point.
What corner is that? Because I'm looking at all four and he's not
me.
There.
Shut your mouth and listen. When you have the best in Pittsburgh, to fall back on, to get advice from on a daily basis, you will outthink your opponent every time.
All I'm saying is this, and I mean, Church, the bottom line is this. There is a key to this match. Do you know what it is? The torture rack, and I'll tell you why. Brady Pierce gets Ryan Rain up in that torture rack. It's over. Ryan Rain had back surgery. That's where Ryan Rain's been. He had a couple herniated discs, I think. And I mean, Ryan Rain's back from surgery. Could you imagine if Ryan Rain is up in that torture rack? He's going to tap immediately. I mean, that it's surgically repaired back there. Especially the power of Brady Pierce. Bending, stretching, hurting. This is going to be a rough one. Hip toss and a beauty by Brady Pierce. And Rain outside the ring. Back in he goes. Oh, he just pushes it. Oh, look at that. He just spit in the face of the PA Regional Champ. What cojones this man has.
Ryan Rain getting in the head of Brady Pierce.
And back elbow by Brady Pierce. Rain up and down on the surgically repaired back of Ryan Rain. Pierce now working that back. I know it's going to happen here. Send him off as a corner up and a power slam. More pressure on the spine of Ryan Rain, loosening it up for that torture rack. And I feel bad if he gets cinched into that.
Two count only by Brown and Serve.
It's Bo Browning.
Popping first.
I give up. Pierce now in complete control of this matchup. Oh, face first to the turnbuckle. And Pierce showing Rain why he is the rightful PA Regional Champion. Ooh,
yeah.
Shot to the midsection.
Cheating.
Cheat? What do you mean cheat?
Brady Pierce is putting Ryan Rain in the corner and beating on him while he's in the corner. That is illegal.
Look at you making up rules as we go here. Two and referee Bo on top of things.
Ryan Rain is in the ropes if he's in the corner. Is he not?
He has it a count of five, right? You've always pointed that out.
No, it is illegal to do that.
Guys take usually the count of 20. Up and over. Oh, wait a minute. Has him up. Look at the power of the inspiration. Brady Pierce in suplex. What a beauty. One, two, and no. It is going to take a lot more than that to defeat Ryan Rain. I will say that.
Two count only by Bilbo Baggins.
So what tips do you think Ashton Amherst gave Ryan Rain before this matchup tonight?
Slow, methodical pace. Let Brady Pierce wear himself out. Brady Pierce, the powerhouse, will just continue to go and go. But eventually that power wears out, and that's where stamina and brains come into play. As you can see, it's already started.
I was just about to say, Church, boy, did you say that at the perfect time. I mean, Ryan Rain now in complete control of this matchup, taking advantage of Brady Pierce.
It's because I'm a professional.
Because you're what?
Professional.
Award-winning professional,
right? Award-winning professional.
Yep. You know how many of the fans, never mind, I'm not even going to end it. I tell you what, Ryan Rain now punishing, trying to decimate Brady Pierce.
Ryan Rain being smart, he's got the count of five to be able to break that. Working over Brady Pierce on the ropes.
Pierce now. Oh, wait a minute. Rain going to get the big man over. And oh, beautifully executed suplex. One, two,
and three.
Almost a three count.
Really? Bilbo, really? You couldn't get to three?
His name is Bo. Checking on Brady Pierce now, seeing if he wants to go ahead and submit. Oh, wait a minute. Now that reverse trend lock down to the ground here.
5 minutes gone by.
Trying to wear the big man down. Ryan Rain is taking it to the PA Regional Champion. Oh, knee to the spine. I felt that from here, Church.
Doesn't matter how powerful you are. If you're laying down on the mat, that power is useless.
Yeah, but Ryan Rain now in complete control of this matchup. He really wants that PA Regional Champion. Exclusive wants to walk out of here with nothing but gold around our waists tonight.
And they're going to do it.
Could they go 2 for 2 tonight? That is the question. So I see you got a new little group of buddies in Exclusive here.
They're
Rain
my
now.
Friends. They've always been my friends.
And Brady Pierce coming back here now, sending Rain to the ribs. Oh, wait a minute now. Oh, but Ryan Rain putting that impact and that momentum to a stop with that reverse swinging neckbreaker. And only a two count. Referee Bo on top of things as usual. Now, wait a minute. Now, Ryan, oh, look at that, trying to twist the head of the Inspiration, Brady Pierce.
He's trying to pop it like a pimple.
Hey, he's trying to do what he has
on
to
prom
do.
Prom night. You know him all about those.
What?
You had a bunch of pimples on prom night, didn't you?
No, actually, I didn't. I had a very nice complexion, thank you. But I'm not going to get into that.
You pimply-faced brat.
Jesus. Back to the matchup. And Ryan Rain now trying to squeeze ahead. Oh, one, two, going for a quick pinfall. And Brady Pierce just in the nick of time kicking out of that one. Ryan Rain has to be frustrated right now. Frustrated as all hell. I mean, he's doing everything, pulling out every kind of, like, arsenal he can, and it's not working. Oh, wait a minute. Rain's calling it. He says it's over here. I don't know, Church. Your man, your buddy here is giving, pretty much giving Brady Pierce too much time here. And, oh, foot to the face. I knew it.
That is not going to be pretty in the morning.
No, it's not. And I'll tell you what, Pierce, like I said before, Ryan Rain gave him too much time to just catch his thoughts. Catch him. He saw Rain come down. He put that big foot and delivered it to him. Look at the Inspiration, Brady Pierce. He's getting fired up now. Clothesline. And another one. And the Inspiration, Brady Pierce, is all sorts of shades of pissed off. Up and flew. Face first to the mat.
I've seen about 16 rule violations already.
Oh, come on now. Pierce up and over, clotheslines Ryan Rain. Oh my goodness, picked him up, sidewalk slam. One, two, and no. Ryan Rain has just squeezed out of that three count. I'll tell you what, that was close, Church. Real close.
Yes.
Pierce almost retaining the title once again, I'll point out, against Ryan Rain.
He cheated last time. He's going to cheat again. I can guarantee it.
Ryan Rain was the one disqualified. Thank you. If anybody's cheating. Oh, man, the referee.
Bilbo's down. Bilbo's down.
Oh, no. We have no referee. Referee Bo was just drugged right in front of Ryan Rain. And oh, wait a minute. What's Roberts doing in here? Oh, wait a minute. Roberts. William Roberts was the man that Brady Pierce. Spinebuster and a beauty. Oh my God, are you kidding me? No, no. One, two, three, it's over.
We have.
No,
a
no.
New.
Here is your winner and the new.
She's not even a part of.
Up and over. Wait a minute. One, two, three. It's over. What?
Here's your winner.
Oh, kidding me? Here comes Matthews to the aid of Pierce. It's about damn time. Ryan Rain throwing out the ring. Matthews. And Mr. Roberts going at each other like wild bulls here. Oh, no. Now we're going to see this. What is this connection between William Roberts and Ryan Rain? That's what I want to know. Oh, man. Pierce can barely get up. I mean, these guys are decimating. Decimating both Robert. They're decimating both Pierce and Matthews. You know why William Roberts interfered in this? I mean, that is the man that Brady Pierce defeated for that PA Regional Championship.
Ryan Rain should be your true victor here tonight. Getting screwed over by Ron Swoggle, and then Brady Pierce cheating and pulling the tights of Ryan Rain to get the three count.
What is this connection between William Roberts and Ryan Rain? Are we seeing maybe a third member of exclusive. I'll tell you what, if Roberts is to join exclusive, that is going to be one hell of a faction right there. And nobody, I don't think anybody's going to be able to contain, but I'll tell you what, thank God Scotty Matthews come out and come to the aid of Brady Pierce. This could have been a lot uglier.
And still, the Pennsylvania Regional Heavyweight Champion, the Inspiration, Brady Pierce.
And one thing about Brady Pierce, and I will say this, Church, cheaters never win.
Cheaters always win.
Really?
Look, Brady Pierce won.
Aw, oh, stop it.
Here's somebody who stood in this very ring, holding this very microphone, and has presented to you many of the RWA's greatest matches. Please join me in welcoming back to the RWA, the one, the only, Adam Montgomery!
Adam Montgomery?
Doesn't he get music?
Adam Montgomery, a legend here. Not only that, a legend in this indie business, and I'll say this now. Adam, welcome back for this event here. And it is amazing to see him back in an RWA ring.
Good evening, Wisconsin!
Oh, there's
it
David.
It never gets old.
The following is a four-team gauntlet for the vacant RWA Tag Team Championship. In this match, two teams will start. The only way to be eliminated is by pinfall, submission, countout, or disqualification. After each fall, the winning team will receive a four-second break period. And the last team standing will be named the brand new RWA Tag Team Champions.
You think we could have got a returning Adam Montgomery and a working microphone?
Let us all find out which team drew number one.
I will give them that. They are a hungry tag team, but man, are they jerks.
No, they're not. They're awesome.
Oh, let me guess. You're friends with these
they're
guys, too.
They're friends with mine.
Of course they are. Sean Carr and Cage making a wedding. I'll tell you what, man. Oh, uh-oh. Carr got the mic, and he's usually the mouth of these
first
two.
First of all, you people suck.
He didn't lie there. They do.
You people here in West Newton, Pennsylvania, you hillbilly inbred hicks should be honored that Cage and Sean Carr would even show up.
I agree.
You suck. Now, secondly, why we're here, the RWA Tag Titles. Couldn't help but notice that we drew number one. And number two, I had a glance at the sheet and it said, The Circle. Hey. Shut up, I'm talking.
These fans better watch. Cage is known to go into the crowd and slap some people.
Going forward, because you people are just moronic and won't let me talk. I see that team number two is the Circle. Now, what's funny about that is I think there's only one member of the Circle, and isn't that Ryan Mitchell?
That's right. Ryan Edmonds' career ended
cheering?
Last month.
No one in the back likes him. Pretty much a handicap match.
So Ryan Mitchell, why don't you just...
Uh-oh, here we go. Ryan Mitchell making his way to the ring, and I wonder what they're going to do here. I mean, he's right, though. There's only one member of the circle left, and that is Ryan Mitchell. Mitchell making his way to the ring, and I'll tell you what, can you hear this crowd? Sean Carr opened his mouth at the wrong time. The Steel City Prodigy making his way to the ring, and I don't know, Church. I hope he has an opponent tonight. I mean, Carr did bring up a valid point. There's only one member of the circle left here.
If there's one thing that I know about Ryan Mitchell, he comes through in a clinch.
All right, we got streamers and... Like I said, it's always a party when Ryan Mitchell's in the ring. And I'll tell you what, this crowd is going bananas. And just 2 months ago, he was one of the most hated individuals in this building. That is crazy. So what's your opinion on Mitchell now, Church?
Ryan Mitchell is a great athlete, despite the fact that the River Dirt here seem to enjoy his entertainment.
You know, I said last month that the circle was never supposed to be what it became, and I wasn't kidding. So, you two, you know, I know you guys, I know you're a hell of an athlete. Obviously, I'm not going to be stupid enough to come up here out here by myself. The circle is not broken. The circle is reborn tonight. And what it was supposed to be in the first place. Now the guy that, oh yeah, you were right. Nobody in the RWA locker room likes me and I don't care. But no one said I had to go to the RWA locker room to get a partner.
What?
You guys might remember this guy, but hey Aaron, why don't you hit his music so he can come out here right now.
God! No way. There's no way. Are you kidding me? Are we gonna see something that... No way. There's no way he's here. Are you kidding me? Oh my God, it's Chris Taylor! Chris Taylor is back! Chris Taylor is back in RWA! Oh my God! I can't believe it! Mitchell and Taylor are reunited! The original circle, that's right! Finally! Finally! Taylor back in RWA! We are gonna see what hell of a tag team match tonight! Team CK has definitely bit off more than they can chew! Mitchell's a genius!
Wow, that's all I can say.
You look disappointed, Church. Oh, that's right. Last time Taylor was in town, he didn't have very happy words for you. That's right. I remember this. Taylor,
I can't hear a word you're saying. Shut your damn mouth. I don't know what the hell you're saying.
I can't believe it, folks. This is one of the best. This is probably one of the greatest moments in RWA history. Chris Taylor is back, and he's back to stay. Taylor and these two. Of course, with the Circle faithful there. I cannot believe it. This crowd is going nuts. Believe what I am seeing, the reunion of Mitchell and Taylor. Team CK
Sean Carr insulting the fans here. Oh, man, Team CK's yelling at the fans. They should be focused on the reunited circle in Taylor and Mitchell. And I'll tell you what, and I'll tell you what's crazy. Actually, you know what? I'm looking here in my data banks on my phone here. I'm Googling some things here.
Good God, really?
Yes, I have to. I'll tell you why. It has been 2 years. 2 years since Mitchell and Taylor have tagged together. Chris Taylor's going to start things off, and how sweet is this? Chris Taylor has done some stuff in the Indies. I mean, he just got back. He had a heavyweight title run in another federation. And I'll tell you what, congratulations to him, man. I mean, he's making some marks here. And what a mark he's made tonight, returning to RWA. Sean Carr yelling at the fans here, calling one of our fans, Samuel L. Jackson, making fun of him, and oh, man. Taylor pretty much returning the favor now to Sean Carr. These two about to lock it up here. I'm cheesing right now. I cannot believe pretty much not only Ryan Mitchell's good friend, I'll actually say it, heck with it, my good friend Chris Taylor in that ring right now. I am excited. These two locking it up here. Oh, man, Sean Carr now trying to break some hearts. They're squeezing the melon here. Chris Taylor, what's going to happen now? Oh, shot the midsection.
It has been a very long time since Chris Taylor has been here in RWA. Hell, I'll even say it. Welcome back, Chris.
Shot to the shoulder block there, and up and over. Wow, what agility by Taylor. Up and over. Here he comes. Shoulder block by Chris Taylor, and telling Sean Carr where to go and how to get there. Off the ropes. Oh, down and under. Man, are these two. Oh, what a takedown by Carr. And there's his receipt from Taylor. Take to the midsection, up and over. Leg takedown by Taylor. Oh my God, these two. Double drop kick. Give
back
it up to
forth,
them.
Back and forth. What beauty in that game.
Taylor actually holding his hand out to respect, showing a sign of respect here. I mean, what agility and talent both of these individuals have. Oh, what a, such a disrespectful man. But I will say, Team CK, one of the ultimate tag teams here in RWA, and I'll tell you why. Not only do you have speed, versatility, and just ring prowess in Sean Carr, Cage here, strength, brutality, you got pretty much everything that makes a perfect wrestler into two wrestlers. Pretty much the perfect tag team, I think, to Team CK.
Absolutely, I will agree with you.
Wow.
I'm a professional, I can agree with
you.
Oh
God, here we go again. These two about to lock it up, Mitchell and Cage, and oh man. Mitchell got himself one big boy in the ring now. Handle him. These two about to lock it up here, and I'll tell you what, Cage is a bulldozer. I've seen him maul through people.
How would you like to meet him in the Dark Alley?
I wouldn't. I met them in the dressing room. That's enough for me. Well, wait a minute. Cage getting a little frustrated here. And oh! Man, I tell you what if Mitchell gets caught with one of them huge? Oh, wait a minute. Catches him, and ooh! Punch to the face, and there it is, that brutality and strength I was talking about in Cage. Off the ropes, underneath, Mitchell, flying knee. One thing about Team CK, they're not afraid to fight anybody. And there goes Carr trying to get into the mix, and Mitchell takes him down. Taylor and Mitchell already communicating here. It looks like they haven't lost a step, not teaming up for 2 years.
Absolutely not, and that is just from pure old-fashioned friendship and everything else.
And I can actually say this officially now, the Circle is still intact here in RWA. Thought it was destroyed last month, of course, with Ryan Edmonds departing, but the Circle is still intact. And Taylor now, pretty much, if there's anything that's not going to be intact anymore, it's going to be Sean Carr's arm, because Taylor looks like he's going to twist it right off.
Ryan Mitchell, Chris Taylor, in and out, back and forth. Great tag team wrestling on their side. Same way with Sean Carr and Cage.
5 minutes.
It's just an amazing back and forth, back and forth. Whoever is going to end up on top is going to have the bumps and bruises to prove they've been in a war just for this first match. And we still have more matches afterwards.
Yes, we have a bunch of teams here, folks. And I'll tell you what, they put question marks all through my run sheet here. Why? Because they don't want to know. Oh, my. Now, that was what you call a plate of chops. And I'll tell you what. The Circle now sending Carr into the ropes. Oh, double elbow. That never gets old. Double elbow. Oh, wait a minute. They better turn around. Cage is right behind him. Oh, wait a minute. Misses. Double drop kick and a beauty. And Team CK is out of it right now. Cage is frustrated. Look at him out there. I mean, him and Carr trying to regroup, replan, because they were not expecting Mitchell to have a partner. And, man, did they get their just desserts. Oh, boy. Uh-oh. Here they come. Flying body press.
Good God. Everybody went everywhere.
Oh, my goodness.
Ryan Mitchell taking out Cage. Taylor taking out Carr. We got a hell of a car accident out in front of the ring.
And I'll tell you what, brutality at its best. The Circle handling things here. Suplex by Taylor. Could this be it? And I tell you what, it's going to take a lot more than a suplex to defeat Team CK.
Absolutely.
Again, Taylor now. Oh, wait a minute. Reversal by Carr. And, oh, Cage. I'll tell you what now. Cage, that was smart tag team wrestling right there. And taking Chris Taylor off his game there. A little bit of a dirty, cheap shot. But, hey, guess what? Referee didn't see it, I guess.
Everything is fair when you're going for gold.
Oh, catches him. Did you see the power of Cage catching him up here? Power slam! Oh, my goodness. One.
Davey Boy style.
You took the words right out of my mouth. I was thinking the same thing.
Two count only by Ron Swoggle.
Just call him Ron, please.
Ron!
Now, Cage in complete control of this matchup. Oh, my goodness. This is going to hurt. Oh, my goodness. Vicious clothesline, too, and did you see the power of Cage just run over the body of Chris Taylor?
Just driving his head and back and neck to the mat with such force. And Ron Swan.
Odd.
With Ryan Mitchell. Maybe he should pay attention to the actual match itself.
And Sean Carr delivering a dirty cheap shot to Chris Taylor. Hitting him right in the Jonas Brothers.
I'll agree with Ryan Mitchell. The referee should not be paying attention to Ryan. He should be paying attention to the match.
Oh, look at this. Carr is just teasing Mitchell, taunting Mitchell, wanting Mitchell to come over those ropes so the referee will turn his back. That's why Team CK is so dangerous. They know how to play the game here when it comes to tag team wrestling. I mean, they've held multiple titles in multiple federations. These guys are very well known around the indie circuit. One, two, and almost a three count. Sean Carr again. What the heck? He's just, oh, look at that. He's pointing his, he's choking Chris Taylor with his boot.
If the referee doesn't see it, it doesn't matter.
Of course you'd say that. Mitchell's not even, oh, come on.
Ron Swoggle getting involved with Mitchell once again.
There wasn't even a tag. I mean,
there was a tag. I saw one.
Of course you did. Sidewalk slam, and that is what Cage does his best, punishes his opponents. And again, Taylor kicking out of it. Taylor's taking a beating for the last, I'd say 3 minutes, 4 minutes? I mean, it's been nothing but just hellacious. What are these teams, whoever wins this match, what are they going to be like for the next tag team to come out of here?
Well, you got to imagine that no matter what happens, in the end, the team that's coming out is going to have the advantage. They are going to be fresh. They will have not gone through a war.
Taylor fighting back, catching Cage with an elbow and a big boot. Taylor's to the second rope, up and over, drop kick. Taylor needs to tag Mitchell in. He needs to get over it. He needs to make this tag. Can he do it?
His 10 count.
Referee at the count of four. Man, you,
10 minutes gone,
I can't even hear myself think. This crowd's going nuts. Mitchell's tagged in. Sean Carr's tagged in. Carr misses with a clothesline. Mitchell returning it. Drop kick by Mitchell. And a beauty, another one. Two drop kicks in a row. Mitchell up and over. Spinebuster double A style. One, two, and oh, Cage breaking up the count. Smart tag team wrestling. Mitchell, a little light on his feet here. Cage misses with a clothesline. Oh, clothesline by Mitchell. Uh-oh. We've seen this before. Mitchell now doing what he does best, climbing to the ropes. Handling his business. One of the best elbow drops I've seen delivered. Oh, did you see how far he flew?
Picture perfect as always.
Up and oh, flying forearm. Up and oh, thought we were gonna catch a bulldog air by Taylor. Oh, kick to the midsection, and there goes Cage. Delivering that, just those powerful blows, and oh my goodness, like a locomotive, and oh, he misses! Call him Miley Cyrus, he just came in like a wrecking ball and just crashed.
Sean Carr up, telling the fans to, well, you heard him.
Super kick, Taylor Cutter! Ryan Mitchell with the pinfall! Chris Taylor and Ryan Mitchell victorious. The Circle. I wonder who the next team is. Team CK can barely stand right now. God, what the hell's what? Wait a minute, what? Taylor just attacked Mitchell. What's going on here, Chris? What the hell are you doing, man? What the? Oh my God! Another Taylor Cutter. He just slapped his own best friend in the face. What the? What? What's going on here?
Apparently, the Circle is broken.
Oh my God, Chris Taylor just... What the hell, Chris? Fans, I can't believe this just happened.
And now,
let us all find out which team drew number 3.
Okay, Mitchell's lying in the ring. Chris Taylor has walked out of here. I mean, basically, well, with the music giving it away, it's definitely Zubov. And I... All right, Zubov and Brock Singleton making their way to the ring. I don't know what the hell they're going to do here. Ron's going to ring the bell here. Just Zubov's apologizing. I mean, he's rolling him over and just...
1, 2, and 3. The circle has been eliminated from the tag team title.
The team of Brock Singleton and Zubov.
I mean, the crowd's booing, but I mean.
Singleton and Zubov will now receive a 45-second rest period.
45-second rest period, but I'll tell you what, I mean, Mitchell can't believe what just happened. I mean, pretty much Brock Singleton and Zubov got a bye. Basically a bye week right there. I mean, my God, they're like the Denver Broncos of this match. And getting a bye week, I can't believe it. Mitchell, I'm still shocked about Taylor. I cannot believe Chris Taylor turned his back, slapped his best friend in the face. I'm like, wait a minute. Another man who won an award tonight, unlike like you, many awards. What? Wait. What the hell? In a long time. Last time I saw the, you know what? No. What's wrong with Raver? What is Raver? Are you kidding me? Church. I'm shaking
right
now. I got
goosebumps.
If this is what I think is happening right now. This is a very dark time in RWA. Oh my God! Oh my God! Turn to Chris Taylor. Deep. Generation Dead is in RWA. These guys have held multiple tag team titles, and they have they actually are tag team champions in another division that I know of. But
this is
not going to be
good for Zubov and Brock Singleton.
Generation Dead has been unleashed on RWA. Oh my God. Wait a minute. G Raver has unleashed hell here in RWA, and that hell is gory. And oh man, look at this. Zubov and Brock Singleton know they gotta punish these two. Because these two can take a lot of punishment. but they can deliver it as well.
We have seen the amount of punishment Raver has taken over the years. We've seen the punishment that Gory can take. Together, these two might very well be unstoppable.
And Gory now caught. Bulldog by Zubov. And give it up to Zubov. I mean, he is taking this not lightly. He's taking this very seriously. Zubov is not letting up, and that is exactly what you have to do against Gory. Oh, flying clothesline by the Russian-American Zubov, and I'll tell you what, I cannot believe it. We have witnessed two returns to RWA, and man, what vital assets these guys are. And wait a minute.
I'm more excited about the Jason Gory return than the Chris Taylor return. And that's saying a lot because it's Chris Taylor. And after what we saw Taylor do, I am speechless when it comes to who. It's just amazing.
Oh, Singleton catches him in midair. Oh! Whipping him over. What a suplex. Pretty much T-bone. Up and over. And oh, my goodness. Singleton now taking at the Raver. Singleton and Zubov are playing smart tag team wrestling here. I mean, they are taking at the Generation Dead. Generation Dead is in RWA. I cannot believe it, but something I noticed during the interview with when Raver won the awards, did you notice I'm more discouraged, G. Raver? Just a very quiet, not as warm, not as acceptable to the fans. He was just very cold, I noticed. And I know G. Raver personally, and I tell you what, he's not like that. And right now, oh my God, there's what makes Gory one of the most feared, biting the head of Zubov. Into the corner, Zubov goes, and Gory, what he does best, taking control.
Jason Gory, former champion here in RWA, slapping his partner, G. Raver, in the face, trying to wake him up, I guess.
Oh, kick to the spinal cord, and G. Raver down two. You realize whoever wins this becomes the RWA Tag Team Champions.
Yes.
Generation Dead has been unleashed in RWA. I'm going to say that 100 times, folks. I cannot believe what I'm seeing right now. Tags Gory in. These two are one of the most lethal combinations in tag team wrestling. I've seen this firsthand before. Oh, my God. Did you see the rake in the back? Look at these two. Just like a pack of wild wolves just attacking Zubov right now. Choking him. I can't believe this. Oh, my goodness. Jason Gory doing what he does best and punishing Zubov. Look at the pain on Zubov's face, Church.
Jason Gory knows how to punish, how to inflict pain, how to maim, and he is taking full advantage of all of that knowledge right here, right now.
He is punishing the hell out of Zubov. I mean, Singleton and Zubov, don't get me wrong, they're a good tag team. You saw how they were victorious last month, Church. But man, they got their work cut out for them when it comes to Gory and Raver. And I'll tell you what, Generation Dead is just taking over this matchup. And look at them go. Gory now. Oh, kick to the midsection. Gory just punishing. Punishing his opponents. And one thing about Gory, he enjoys to punish people. Oh, there's a right by Gory. And now Gory and Raver sending Zubov into the opposite corner. Here comes Raver up and over. Drop kick. Oh! What Jason Gory does best, punish. And here comes Raver!
Beautiful Raver's corner clothesline from Gory. And then again from G. Raver.
Almost sacrificed himself.
5 minutes.
Up and oh my goodness. Brock Singleton can just stand there and watch. I mean, he's motionless right now. He's shocked. This is taking everybody by surprise. Jason Gory has returned to RWA. Chris Taylor, who I'm still speechless about him, returns to RWA. This has been a great night for RWA in a whole.
What are they putting those masks?
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. It's working. Graver off the ropes. Catches him. Wait a minute. Zubov. Uh-oh. Zubov, the power. Catching Raver and stopping Raver's aerial assault. Can Zubov get over and tag his partner? Referee Ron on a count of four. We're at five here. Can Zubov pretty much tag in the tank known as Brock Singleton? And when this man gets going, he's like a bull in a china shop. And Singleton's tagged in, so is Gory. Oh my goodness. And Brock Singleton, here he goes. T-bone suplex. And a beauty. Singleton taking it to Jason Gory. Send him up and over. Back body drop and a beauty. Gory's in trouble.
Just working over the back nonstop. Suplex after suplex after suplex.
Wow, look at the power of Brock Singleton. He had him up there a good, what, 20, 30 seconds? One, two, and no. Brock Singleton asking the ref, just maybe was that a three count? Just maybe. But like I said before, Gory can take a bunch of punishment. He's taking it right now, especially that European uppercut that was just delivered. Gory now in trouble. Brock Singleton sends him another. Here comes, well, wait a minute, Raver grabbing the foot of Brock. This is like a new Raver we're seeing here. A man possessed up and over and pretty much
up and over and
Brock
down on
out.
The floor. Oh, good God. You know what this means, don't you?
Which way is Gory going to go? Oh, my God.
Good God.
Pretty much a spiraling death sickle. There, I'll coin that one.
There you go.
Setting them out there, and wait a minute. What
See
is Raver
going? Getting set up.
Here comes Raver up and catches Brock Singleton.
Into
Holy
the first or second row they went.
Criminally, that's insane. Oh my God, he took him out. Women and children are all scared right now. Generation Dead is here, folks.
Well, if you had one of them flying at you, wouldn't you be scared too?
Not only them and Brock Singleton. Like I said, yes. We've had quite a few occasions where Raver has jumped at us. Back in the day, Gory, when he was...
Yeah.
When they were
and
both...
And I ran every time.
But one thing, I will say this. Did you ever hear the saying, good friends, better enemies? I will say this. Jason Gory and G. Raver are pretty much the opposite of that. And I'll say why. These guys have been at it for how long?
He's biting his fingers.
We've seen how many wars between Gory and Raver? Quite a few. And again, oh, wait a minute. Raver to the ropes. Oh, my goodness. How much pressure and impact do you think Brock Singleton just took with that? Wait a minute, Zubov. They better turn around. Double spear.
Double spear by Zubov. Wait a minute.
Is that Team CK? What the heck are they doing out here? Why is Team CK out here? Zubov better...
Zubov has unfinished business with them, if you remember.
That's right.
He's got his attention turned to Team CK. Meanwhile, Generation Dead is in the ring.
Alone.
Alone with Brock Singleton.
Singleton has Gory up. Oh, no, there's the mist. Wait a minute, Raver. Zubov better get in that ring, and I mean now. Oh my God, Gory and Raver to the top. There it is. What they are known for, two and three. Generation Dead.
your winners of the match, and Moo!
Can always back it up.
Yeah, damn right.
Wrestlers I never laid eyes on. And I'll tell you what, Ash Dammer's making his way to the ring now, and he has his hands full. A man who.
Oh, son of a bitch.
Oh, quit it.
Here comes the longest goddamn entrance in indie wrestling history.
Did you have to say that? Honestly. Did you have to say that?
Say what?
That ignorant word.
What?
Honestly. Show the man respect. He's been in the business for how long? And he's our RWA heavyweight champion. He's fought long and hard to get where he's at today. There we go. Brody loves RWA.
Well, good for him. I hate him.
Oh, Ash Damers wants him to come in now. Oh, wow. What a sign of disrespect there. Kicking the sign. What's this one say now? Lodi what?
Lodi needs an enema.
Lodi needs coffee. Really, Church?
A lobotomy. A new nasal passage.
Team Fearless for Life! Lodi for mayor, president.
I'll move to Canada.
Look at that, handing out souvenirs to the fans. A man that appreciates the fans and appreciates his business. That's right, Lodi. I'm proud that he's our champion.
I hate the River Dirt. I hate the fact that he's our champion.
Well, I'll tell you what, he has one hell of a contest tonight. And he has pretty much the toughest challenge, I think. He has one of the toughest challenges. Sorry, folks, we can't even hear ourselves think. This crowd is going bananas. And it is for that man right there. RWA Heavyweight Champion, Lodi. just handed Ashton Amherst's wife a sign. I can't believe it. Oh my God. Amherst has his title. Lodi just disappeared. Where'd Lodi go?
I really hate Guns N' Roses.
I think you just hate Guns N' Roses because it is the intro music to that man sitting in that corner right there, the RWA Heavyweight Champion, I love saying that, Lodi. Ashton Amherst has his hands full tonight, but so does Lodi. This is going to be one heck. I can't wait for this match.
With a 60-minute time limit, and it is for the RWA Heavyweight Championship. Your referee for the match is Bill Browning.
No, Bo Baggins.
Oh, stop it.
Introducing first, the challenger, weighing in at 202 pounds, he wrestles out of the wrestling capital of the South, Atlanta, Georgia. And he represents exclusive. Here is the best in Pittsburgh, Ashton Amherst. And his opponent, weighing in at 225 pounds from West Hollywood, he is the RWA Heavyweight Champion, Lodi!
Lodi getting an ovation here from the West Newton crowd here in RWA, and I'll tell you what, Ashton Amherst has been stating on her social media, Twitter, Facebook, whatever you want to call it, everywhere he's been stating that he has watched Lodi throughout his youth, and tonight he defeats somebody that he used to watch in his childhood for that RWA title.
Well, Lodi's about 60. So, of course, you know, like, we've all watched him as a kid. And Ashton Amherst, being the best in Pittsburgh, is going to beat Lodi here tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you really are, so you're calling it already, you're stating.
Yeah, damn right I am.
So you're stating your buddy, Ashton Amherst, is going to defeat Lodi here tonight.
Yes.
Okay. I'm not calling this one. I am not making a prediction, and I'll tell you why. Both of them are some of the best athletes I've seen in that ring. Lodi and I will admit this, even though he gets on my nerves, Ashton Amherst. Ashton Amherst is a former RWA champion. He knows how to hold himself in that ring, and I've seen him do amazing things. So tonight, it's pretty much even down the middle between these two, in my opinion. Look at this already, asking the referee, Bo, to check Lodi. He's already playing mind games with him, Church.
You better watch. That referee was a little happy earlier tonight.
Oh, stop it.
But you are right, Ashton Amherst playing mind games with Lodi.
This
making
is
him
funny.
Wait.
I can't
making
believe it.
Wait.
They are screaming. They are upsetting the challenger here, thinking, need to get in the ring. Amherst is getting a little upset here, folks, and I'll tell you what. Lodi begging the challenger. That's right, begging Amherst to get in this ring. These two about to lock it up here. And there, our main event has officially started. Oh, look at these two back and forth now. Lodi putting the challenger, Amherst, in the corner here.
Lodi cheating already.
What
cheating. He's not cheating.
Look at that. He backed him into the corner, wouldn't let him out, and then he went to rip for the hair. Luckily, it was just the bandana.
What do you mean, what hair? There's no hair there to pull. Are you kidding me?
Ashton Amherst has hair on his head.
Yeah,
he is,
but
not
it's,
bald.
It's really not. It's not like long hair. It's not like Ryan Mitchell hair. It's more like you can't pull that type of hair.
Lodi going for a cheap shot. Ashton Amherst beating him to the punch, though.
Oh, stop it. Oh, look at this. Lodi catching him. One, two, and oh, man, we almost had enough. We almost had a quick main event.
It's a good thing Ashton Amherst is the best in Pittsburgh. He was able to kick out of that pinfall attempt, even though Lodi was pulling the tights.
What? Oh, my God. Is this going to be like this whole main event? Lodi throwing Amherst through the chairs. That looked like something out of Domino Alley. Lodi now taking control of this matchup and, oh, face first off that ring apron. Like I said before, hardest part of the ring right there. And throws him off through the chairs again, he goes. They better be careful or referee Bo's gonna count him out here. We might see a double count out.
Oh, good God, stay away from here.
And Ashton Amherst thrown through a bunch of chairs right in front of us. This is beautiful, folks.
Jesus,
beautiful.
God.
Lodi now in complete control. That's a Hershey bar. That's a fan. There's a fan literally oh, my God.
He's shoving a Hershey bar in Ashton Amherst's mouth. And that extremely fat fan is upset that her candy bar just got eaten.
They literally took. There is a fan out here literally crying. Two in.
She's bitching a fit. She wanted chocolate later.
Lodi literally took a candy bar and shoved it.
I don't give a damn if it's fair or not.
Literally took the candy bar. Did you just see that? Dirty move by Ashton Amherst. Back and forth this match goes, but I'll tell you what, folks. Ashton Amherst now in control and is trying to pay Lodi back for feeding him some chocolate. I think chocolate is delicious. I don't know why he's so upset.
I like chocolate too, but you don't get it force-fed down your damn throat by Lodi, of all people.
By the way, Lodi, you owe this fan a dollar. Okay, back to the matchup. Amherst choking the heck out of Lodi on that, the neck of that second. Wait a minute. Look who's sitting outside here, William
the
Roberts.
Hammer. What do you call him?
Mr. William Roberts, pardon me.
Damn right, that's what you call him. Yeah, go for
it. Amherst in control. Lodi's out the ring now. And uh-oh, Ashton Amherst doing what he does best, decimating someone from head to toe.
5 minutes gone by. 5 minutes.
Oh, double axe handle. Straight to the cranium of our champion. And the challenger now, kick to the chest also delivering. The challenger, Amherst, now in complete control of this matchup. I mean, there is one thing Lodi does have over Amherst, and I will say this. And that's experience. Definitely in-ring experience.
Lodi at the feet of William the Hammer Roberts. William Roberts putting his hands up in the air saying, I'm not touching him.
Uh-huh. That's because Ryan Rain was banned from ringside, and we saw it. Wait a minute. Oh, look at this.
Yeah, look at this. Lodi attacking an innocent man. For no reason.
What do you mean? You know what? He already knows there's a
William
plan.
William Roberts did not touch Lodi. Am I right?
All right, but I will say this.
Am I right?
Yes.
William Roberts was attacked unprovoked.
But he was going to do something. He saw him grab him. And Amherst throwing Lodi through those chairs, pretty much giving him a receipt from earlier.
Shove some candy bar in his mouth like he did to you, Ashton.
I don't think these fans, I think these fans all hid their food after.
Well, you know the fat ones did at least.
Oh my God. Choking. Ashton Hammer's now choking the life out of Lodi. And William the Hammer Roberts Mr. Roberts, he looks a little upset right now.
Well, he got attacked and it was completely unprovoked. Of course he would be upset.
Oh, now Amherst delivering that right to the skull of Lodi. One, two, and no. It's going to take a lot more than that to defeat the RWA Heavyweight Champion, Lodi. And I'll tell you what, Lodi, last month, victorious here, ending the career of the Ryan Edmonds. A suplex. And that is why Ashton Amherst is one of the best in Pittsburgh. One, he claims he's the best in Pittsburgh. But a lot of competitors out there in Pittsburgh disagree.
He is the best in Pittsburgh. Period.
Amherst off the second turnbuckle and again come crashing down on the skull of Lodi. One, two, and no.
Two count only, says Bilbo Baggins. Obviously not learning to count to three yet.
Bo Browning, can you please repeat that?
I'm saying his name right. Quit getting on me about it.
Amherst now. Lodi's in the corner. Sends him to opposite corner. Amherst lining him up. Oh, knee to the face. Oh, he misses that boot, though. Back, it was a back body drop slash suplex there.
He was going for a Braddock boot. Completely missed. Lodi ducked it. Now both men are down.
And Lodi now. This crowd getting behind Lodi now. Lodi needs that momentum. Lodi needs that something. Because I tell you what, Amherst, once he's in control, he is hard to take down, Church. Once he has the momentum, you are in trouble, especially when you're fighting someone who's hungry for that championship like Ashton Amherst. Back elbow, though. Lodi's starting to come back now. Clothesline. The momentum's starting to shift here. Oh, look at this. Fight, fights, and up and a ball. Oh, shades of Dusty. Off the ropes he goes. Swinging reverse neck breaker.
How many people's gimmicks is he going to steal?
Two. Oh, stop it. How many times can you trash our champion?
As many times as I damn well please.
Oh, God.
I'm an award-winning professional.
You're going to hear this all year.
10 minutes gone by.
He was going for an even flow, and he didn't get it. Wait a minute. Amherst. Perfect fisherman suplex. Almost a three count.
The Fisherman's Wharf suplex.
And wait a minute. Mr. Roberts is outside. He is pacing. He is mad. Oh, wait a
William
minute.
Roberts.
What's going on here? I knew it. Look at this. Roberts interfering now.
You look at the back of William Roberts. That is why he's angry. Lodi just attacking him completely unprovoked.
Oh, kick to the midsection. Even flow DDT. Missed with the chair. One, two, three, it's over!
Lodi cheating!
Eric Stowe, RWA Heavyweight Champion, Lodi!
Lodi victorious, and the odds were against him! Ashton Amherst trying to swing the chair, misses, and catches an even flow for his troubles. Oh, now here we go. Mr. Roberts in the ring. Here comes Ryan Rain. Great. Look at this. It's 3-on-1. It's about to be 3-on-1 here. And Amherst defeated. That's right. Defeat our number one contender. Defeated for that RWA championship. And Lodi's down, folks. I don't know what's happening here. Oh, my God. Roberts and Rain. Robertson Rain have him. Amherst has that title. Oh, here they come. Here comes Scotty Matthews and Brady Pierce. Oh my goodness. Mr. Roberts throwing out the ring. Rain throwing out the ring. And wait a minute. Amherst is stuck in the ring with all three members.
Get out of the ring, Ashton.
I'll say it. Team Fearless. Yeah, that's it. Give a member of Exclusive a little bit of their own medicine. Good. Oh, here we go. Blows him a kiss. Lodi got that title. We're going to see the roles reverse here. What? Why is Lodi not doing? What? Lodi's not going to hit him. Lodi handling it with class. Let me tell you something. Lodi could have took his head off. An Exclusive making their way out of this ring. And you know what? Church, I'll tell you what. Lodi victorious. And again, you were wrong. Lodi is still our RWA heavyweight champion.
Exclusive got screwed here tonight in two different matches. I can guarantee you they will be back again.
I'll guarantee that too. I will say this, I'll agree with you, Church. We haven't heard the last from Exclusive, but I'll tell you what, Lodi victorious, and thank God Scotty Matthews and Brady Pierce came in when they did, and it has been one unbelievable night here. Open season has been, we've seen returns, we've seen everything, and I can't believe it, folks. Lodi, victorious again, our RWA Heavyweight Championship. Again, I'm Mike Dougherty. This, of course,
you shut your mouth. I am your award-winning professional wrestling reverend, Church, and don't you forget it.
Anyways, folks, again, thank you and good night. What hell of a start of year at RWA open season. See you next month.